For those of you just tuning in, I'm Clipper Letdown, and here with me is Leonard French Rocket.
Hello!
Live from a stunning fight thus far between Bruce Ironface Springfield and Truck Benson.
That's for sure. It's just the third round and Ironface is getting handed to him, Clipper.
It seems like every time he tries to punch, Benson lands three heart-stopping haymakers square in his poor, mangled iron face.
I think we're all thankful that round is over.
I can't believe that A, the coroner hasn't called the fight, and B, that Bruce can find which corner is his.
Looks like his eyes are sewn shut.
Now let's go to his corner and hear what his manager, coach, mentor, and cutman has to say to the champ.
He's blitzkrieging my face, Mick. I can't see anything. My eyelids are so swollen shut. You're gonna have to cut me.
Boy, Russ! Quick, Goof, get me the razor!
Here you go.
Now, don't move, Bruce. I'll have you seen in no time.
Towards the end of that round, it was so dark that the whole world looked like a fireworks display.
Oops, there you go. I sort of took a bit too much off of your left eye, huh? But sort that out later. It's just gonna kind of hang around.
Well, I can see, and that's the important part.
Yeah, that's the spirit. Now, dig down deep and go get him.
Actually, I am not sure I want to go back out there.
What do you mean? You want to live forever? Go beat this guy like he just ate your dog!
I can't believe Ironface is walking out to the middle of that ring right now.
Neither can Benson.
There is just so much blood pouring out of his face.
And it looks like Mickey basically took off his upper eyelid on the left side. The whole thing is dangling like a cheap set of eyelashes.
And Benson's right back to business on Springfield's face.
He's laying a merciless assault on Bruce's T-zone clip.
He may have landed 100% of his punches thrown, and they may have all been on his face.
Oh boy, you gotta avoid those!
His face looks like Alsace-Lorraine in 1941.
Mickey is gonna have to chop a lot more of his face off if he expects him to go back out for another round.
I don't know if his mother would recognize him right now.
The referee, Chris Kentripper, has been at this a long time. But you can hear the promoter, Don, from here freaking out every time it seems like you might call the match.
If you think Bruce's face was bad, I hate to see what would happen if you crashed Donald.
Oh boy, what a round! You really are turning things around!
I don't know, Mick. I think I may have nerve damage. I can hardly feel the concussions anymore, and my legs don't feel right.
All right! I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but it's time to bring in the muscles!
I don't know.
Goof, get the suds!
Here you go.
Oh boy, it's time for Rolling Thunder!
Okay. And here we go again.
This is borderline illegal.
Benson wastes no time laying right back into that iron face.
It seems like Springfield couldn't care less. In fact, it seems like he's looking more at Chris Kentripper, the referee.
You couldn't be more right, since Springfield has seemed to have forgotten about Benson and is launching himself at Kentripper. It looks like he's trying to rip his arm off his body.
I don't know who you are or what you're doing here, but you're going down, Kentripper.
Oh man, Bruce just utterly shattered Benson's jaw with his elbow as the truck was coming to Chris Kentripper's aid.
Benson is out for the count.
Get up, Bruce!
Don is furious up there as the Brute Squad rushes the ring.
Utter madness, Leonard. Bodies are flying all over the arena.
This place is eating it up like Bruce Springfield is with Chris Kentripper's torso.
Back to you, Will.